Hey, hi all. Welcome to the webinar. I'm Neha. I look after the product marketing at iMocha. So before we start, there are a few pointers for you all. So feel free to post your questions anytime during the webinar. We have a Q&A session at the end, but you can submit your questions anytime using the Q&A box at the bottom of your screen. Then ensure you have joined with the join audio button in the bottom left corner. And also your volume is turned up on your speaker. So this will ensure there are no audio hassles. And lastly, please fill up the feedback poll. It really helps us get better. All right, so we start. So first of all, the things that you will learn in this webinar. So how to hire exceptional coders with code quality. And the latest skills that we have launched in May. All right, so let's begin with the problem statement first. So we'll discuss the use case. So basic coding assessments don't assess the right skills. So what we're trying to say here is that the basic coding assessments will assess the coding logic of the candidates. Like you can have varying difficulty levels, but it would still be about candidates writing the logic accurately and the code running against the test cases. So this is good for entry-level candidates, but when you're looking at mid to senior level developers, their skills cannot be assessed purely on coding abilities. So their code or coding style that needs to be, you know, maintainable. The coding should be clean, the code should be reliable and secure as well. Now for this, one solution is you can say that the hiring managers can manually review the code. But we all know that manual code reviews are time intensive process. You know, hiring managers simply do not have the time to read the code line by line, and it will obviously hamper their primary task. So this brings us to the solution, that is the code quality. So what is code quality? So code quality is an automated code evaluation process. Okay, it will scan the candidate's code and it will grade it on parameters like complexity, maintainability, and reliability. Okay, it's a completely automated report that will highlight the crucial aspects of a candidate's code at a glance. And again, no manual review required. So we'll just have a look how this looks on the app platform. Yeah, so whenever you log in into your app platform, you can go into the test that you want to, you know, enable code quality for. So before you enable the code quality, let me just tell you that currently we support code quality only for Java and Python version 3 languages. So if you're looking to hire for this skills, you can easily use code quality. Now I will just select the test where I want to, you know, enable code quality for the coding reports. You can go directly into reports. So I'll take this report. You need to go to the questions part. Yeah. So you can select any of the questions. I'll just select one question over here. So this is the question. You can see the question over here. And before enabling code quality, the actual program that is written by the candidate will look over, like you can see it over here. It will look like this. So to enable code quality, I'll have to do it from over here. To enable code quality in your account, you'll first have to speak with your account manager, either your customer success manager or your account manager, and they will do it for you. So once I enable this, yeah, so the report will change into this. So here you can see that now I have something called as major violations, minor violations. I also have a certain grading on the right hand side. Let's go through it one by one. So major violations and minor violations, and in the code, the violations will be color coded as per that. So you can see this is a minor violation. This one matches with this, whereas this one over here is a major violation. And there are two major violations and two minor violations. Now the code quality report will only be generated for answers where the test cases have been compiled. There should be at least one compilation for the code quality report to be displayed. So what are major and minor violations? So major violation generally means a high impact quality flaw in the code. I mean, the code is good, but I mean the code is not good, but there is a certain flaw in the code. Like the test cases will pass, but there is a flaw which will hamper it in the long run. And a minor violation means it's a low impact quality flaw. Like you can decide, you know, whether you can overlook it and still go ahead with the code. Now over here, we have certain other parameters which give the grading for. So one is the cyclomatic complexity. So cyclomatic complexity shows you how complex your code is and in the long run, if it can cause problems or no. So obviously A is a good rating, B is it has medium complexity, C is it is extremely complex, C is high complexity, and D is extreme complexity. So you can decide on basis of this. Second is maintainability. So for maintainability, this shows whether the coding logic will create problems later and can add to technical debts. So if the code or like very low maintainability required, so it can sustain in the long run. Again, B is medium, C is high, and D is that you'll have to be very careful. Like when this code is executed, you'll have to keep checking on this code. And last is reliability. So the reliability is nothing but the ability of the code to perform as intended every time without causing any issues. So again, the reliability ratings will give you like A is there are zero bugs in the code, B is at least one minor bug, C is one major bug, and D is a critical bug. So based on this, you can edit the score of the candidate. Like it can quickly have a glance at the code quality report, and from here, if you are okay with all the parameters and everything, you can click over here and edit the score. Now somebody has already given the score 7. If you want, you can go ahead and give it an 8, or you can even lower the score and say save. Yeah, so this will be done and it will also be recorded. So what code quality will do is code quality will help you assess mid to senior level developers. It will save you hiring time. And importantly, you can identify exceptional coders without any hassles. You will know if the candidate is suitable for working in your organization or can easily adapt to the coding style in your organization. So that was about code quality. Now we can quickly move ahead. And we can see the test that we have launched for this month, that is for May. Yeah. So in the new skills launched, we have launched 4 tests for Microsoft, 2 for Cisco, 5 in software development, and 2 in Python. So that was the update from our end for the month of May. If you have any questions, we'll be happy to take it. All right, so we don't have any questions as of now. So we have floated a webinar in the poll. So if you all can just give the feedback, that would be helpful. And also, we'll be sharing the recording of the code quality along with the other assets like the video and the help article for it. So you all can go through that and also start using code quality for your candidates. All right. I think we don't have any questions. Not an issue. If you have any questions, you can write to me at neha@imoca.io, or you can contact your customer success or account managers and they will help you through. All right. Thank you so much, people. Have a great day.